Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel Skill RPA, and in this session we are going to look at a real-time use case, and this will be a series of sessions like where we will be discussing about a real-time use cases, and we'll be doing all the SDLC, like whatever the software development life cycle we are going to have for an RPA. We are going to have a series of sessions on that same. Like we are going to cover the requirement workshop, and we are going to cover PDD, process definition document, and we are going to cover SDD, solution design document, and we are going to do the development, and also we are going to deploy the process to UiPath orchestrator, and we will be executing it from the UiPath orchestrator. So here we are going to do the complete end-to-end enterprise level automation. And here we are going to use the UiPath RE framework for this implementation as well. And this is the first session for the series of real-time use case supply chain management. And here we are going to discuss the requirements. And here the customer, so like for every RPA process, like we'll be having a business team and the customer as well, right? And here the customer is pragmatic procurement solutions, and the team is procurement team, where they are going to do the supply chain management. Like they want the automation to be implemented for their supply chain management. So for a particular PO number, they just want to capture shipping date and what is the total of the amount, and they just want to go with the procurement application and the agents as well. So let us have a discussion, like let us go in a deep dive for requirement discussion, and it will be followed by the process definition document, and then it will be followed by the solution design document, and then we are going to do the development. So here the requirement is, so the purchase orders are numbers are displayed here in the below, and this is the supply chain management tool. And then for each purchase order in the list, we need to capture the ship date, order total, and the state from procurement application. So what actually we are doing as of now manually, that we are going to discuss it, and we will be discussing like in the PDD how it is going to be when it was automated. So generally what we generally do, so whenever you are going for any requirement workshops, first you need to ask the business that how they are doing as of now manually. So here let me consider as your business user, and I'm a business person, and I'm going to give you the requirements. And here, what generally I do, I'm just going to make you a walkthrough. Like I'll take you through this manual process, what actually I do. So first I'll be opening this URL, and I will be going into this application. And after that, I'm going to click on this procurement anywhere web application, and it will be opened in a new tab. And let us suppose I don't have any credentials with me, and every time it will generate a random credential in the every login. So I'm considering in that way. So the requirement is like I need to open this supply chain management application, and from here I need to open the procurement anywhere application, and the username and password will be keep on changing because I don't want that to be fixed. So I need to capture the username and password from here. So I'll be taking this username, and I will be putting it in the email address, and I'll be taking the password, and I'll be putting it here, and I'll be clicking on the sign in. This is how I generally used to log into the procurement application. And after that, what I will do is I will be downloading this agent territory spreadsheet. And even every time I want to download this, because I'm not sure whether the agents are getting changed for any territory or any state. So I want to make sure that every time I want to download this, because sometimes my backend team is going to update the agents here. So now I'm downloading this Every time when I log in, let me open this Excel. So my Excel got opened, and this is the agent names against each state. And what I do after this is I'll take this purchase number and I'll go to the procurement anywhere application and I'll put this purchase number here. And here from here, I got the details of this particular purchase order. And from this, what I capture is I'll take the state, I'll take the ship date, and I'll take the order detail, order total. So let me take the ship date. I'll be directly putting this here, the ship date, and I'll be taking this order total. I don't want the dollar symbol here, so I'll be keeping this. And for agent, I just need to take the state, and it is IL, and I need to go back to this Excel and I need to filter. I need to filter the state here. And Mitchell Manders is the agent for me. So I'll go here, I'll be selecting Mitchell Manders here. And I'll, in the similar way, I'll go for the next purchase order number. And I got the ship date. I'll be taking the order total. And what is the state I have? I have AL. For AL, I have Grand Brown. I'll go for Grand Brown here. So in the similar way, I need to do for all these PO numbers. Let me pause for a while because everything is same, the repetitive process. So I just doesn't want the video to be so long. So let me pause the video for a while. And then once everything is filled up, then we'll continue. So now we have all the data filled up for all these PO numbers. And the biggest challenge over here is like these PO numbers are not fixed. Like the number of PO numbers we are going to get here is not a fixed. So we just need to, what need to handle, like let us suppose sometimes it can be only one PO number. Sometimes it can have 5 to 10 PO numbers, or like sometimes it can have more than that. But the advantage what we have is like, whatever might be the number of PO numbers, we'll be having it in the same page. It's not going to be a next page or like a navigation won't be available. So now we got all the information here. And once we capture all the information from here, and then we just entered everything here. So I think I missed out to put one PO information. Let me see here. There's a challenge with the manual approach. If that is the bot, then obviously it's not going to do such a miss out. And now I just need to put the ship date here, and then I just need to take the order total. And I just need to look for the state. It is CVO. Let me go for that. It is Mitch Manders. Let me select that guy. Yeah. So if you observe, right, so here there might be a chance that for multiple states, the same person can be there as an agent. And so we just need to handle all these scenarios. So we just need to go only with this mapping based on the state, whatever we got here. So based on the state. So here the requirement is we just need to take the PO number. And we need to search with that PO number. And from here, we need to capture the ship date, total order, and the state. And based on the state from this mapping, we need to get the agent name. And here we need to put the ship date and order total without a dollar symbol. And then we need to select the agent. And then I just need to click on submit. So So this is my actual requirement, and so somehow like I missed out to input some data because I'm doing it manually, but it should be 100 every time. So this is our use case, and in the following sessions we are going to prepare the process definition document, and before going for the process definition document we are going to create the flows, like what actually the as is flow right now and what is going to be the flow to be flow. So there are two things, like we are going to create some flow kind of thing, like how the process is going step by step, and then after creating those flows, then we are going to jump into process definition document. So stay tuned for creating the flows, like as is flow and to be flow, which is much more required for the preparation of the process design document as well as for the developer understanding. So thanks for watching this video, and stay tuned for more videos on the use cases. And we are coming up with a couple of more use cases as well to cover in the series. And please like, share, and subscribe to Skill RPA. Thank you.